Pretending to be a good fisherman's woman, just like Anna Inkin's mum, the gladiator of all fishermen's wives. It makes it a lot easier thinking of you on the sea, where you have to be a month at a time.
I wanted to call the album Fisherman's Woman before I almost wrote the record. Because it was the first lyric I wrote for the record, probably 3 years ago or something.
When you go to bed, you try to sleep by listening to the boat breathing.
It was sort of set in stone that I wanted to write with one instrument only. I wanted to get away from singing on top of a production. It was just something for me to make it more personal while I was working.
The brightest red lipstick on my lips, just like Anna.
David Donald introduced me to Dan Carey, or Mr. Dan as he calls himself, and we sort of hit it off straight away. He started by doing this drum machine thing, so I was like, we're gonna, you know, write on the guitar. And lo and behold, he ended up being the best guitarist I've ever seen, which was really, really amazing, because he just makes the most amazing guitar melodies. And then the songs were born, and it was just all for me there. I only wanted the demos to be the record in the beginning. I wanted it to stay the way it was. And then we just sort of fiddled around. Then met Julian Joseph in a party, who's an amazing jazz pianist. He's like, well, call me if you need me, sort of thing. And we're just sort of dribbling. Okay, then. He came in and did a few songs, like, in 5 seconds. And just incredible. We just sat there listening to him, like, oh, my God. And then we weren't going to have any drums on it, but Samuli was going through London with Moom, and they had a day off, so we thought, oh, it's a good opportunity to try it out, because he's an amazing drummer, he's here, he's quick. And we ended up using that as well, because everything he did was so good. So it just escalated really naturally. It was a very, very natural, naturally born record. It was exactly how I've always wanted to work a record. It just sort of happens. And everybody that sort of took part in the record, we became sort of like a gang almost. And I think we are going to be for a very long time. I don't think we had any rules in writing. Mostly just trying to jam it and have fun doing it. We only worked like 2 hours a day. I'm always trying to run away from having to write and do the work. I'm always like, oh, shall we go, you know, for coffee now? Oh, let's go for lunch. Shall we have wine? Like, distracting, always distracting. I think that's maybe why it took a long time to write, because we could have done it probably in a month, but it took 2 years.
All the same, I miss you. Today has been okay. Today has been okay.
Today has been okay is really sentimental to me. And it's also the first song me and Dan wrote. And it's just really funny to think back on the record, because it was made with so much laughing fits, and yes, it's a quite serious thing. And we were just going crazy sometimes. Today has been okay, very little had to be done on it, because the lyrics were already there. And then sometimes afterwards there's a lyric, Fisherman's Woman, there was a letter. And Sonny Rota also wrote this a letter.
Wrote you this, I hope you got it safe. It's been so long, I don't know what to say. I traveled round through deserts on my horse. Jokes aside, I wanna come back home.
It took such a long time to finish the lyrics on it. We had the first verses and the chorus, and then it just stopped. And I remember we were just you know, when we were playing gigs, we just sang it over and over again, the same thing, because we really wanted to play it live. We were like, couldn't wait.
It's time, meet me on the sunny road.
It sort of became our favorite song. It was a very natural thing for it to become the single. Also, when you hear the record, it is almost the only single, so...
I never married, never had those kids. I loved too many, now heaven's closed its gates.
I did want the video to be animated because I am terrible on film. I'm just like a tin man. So I was really wanting to get the spirit of the record without me having to ruin it.
It's a long, long time ago.
Wes sent us a few video clips, one that just came in sort of with a hand out of the TV and punched me in the face, and that was Ali Taylor.
It's time, meet me on the sunny road.
She literally just gave it to her, didn't really want to dictate it too much, but we have been a pain in the arse to work with because I am very particular on things. I want things to be a certain way and it can be a bit difficult, but I've told her she can slap me when it's ready.
This time as one will find which way to go. Now come and meet me on the sunny road.